चाइल्ड लेबर मैम, वी गेव सम एग्जांपल्स ऑफ दिस आल्सो ऑफ मैम साहिबे आलम, अ चाइल्ड हु वर्कड मैम
as a rat picker.
Yes, ma'am. Who worked as a rat picker, and ma'am, a child who is in the profession of making bangles, ma'am.
Yes. Very good. Very good, Mohit. Akshar, would you like to add on? Akshar? Okay. So, as Mohit said rightly, The Lost Spring, as the title suggests, is a story about those children who are in the spring of their age. The childhood is supposed to be the spring of the whole human life, because we are all bubbling up with energy, flourishing, growing up, and how the time of spring, the time of enjoyment, memories is all lost because of the child labor. So firstly, we come to know about Sahibe Alam. Sahibe Alam is a young boy who is working as a rag picker. Yes, so he is working as a rag picker, and the boy is now focusing on that how he will get something or the other for himself. Now this something or the other, this what he is looking for, gold, is related to that what he is going to get. Sometimes he get a 10 rupee note, sometimes he gets something useful for himself in this heap of garbage. For the people, means for the elders of the slum in Simapuri, the elders of the slum, for them there is nothing like that, that they are able to relate to. It is a means of survival only. But for children like Sahibe Alam, this all refers to something that is very precious for them. And they enjoy a lot when they find out that note or something valuable in that heap of garbage. Yes, apart from this, we'll talk about more on the character of Sahibe Alam. Then we meet the next character, the whom Ange Young meets. He is Mukesh. Now, Mukesh lives in Firozabad. He is born into the family of bangle makers. Now, he doesn't want to adopt the professional, ancestral profession of bangle making. Rather, he wants to be a motor driver mechanic. And he even dreams of flying an aeroplane someday. So, in contrast, that Sahibe Alam, who is a rag picker, he desires that he should be going on with this. But so after some days, Anjum finds that he is working in a tea stall, getting a monthly wage of 800 rupees per month. And his three times meal is also given by the tea stall owner. In contrast, Mukesh is there, who has been forced many a times, but still he is working as a motor mechanic, and he is keeping his dream alive. He is not going by all those things. Yes. So on this note, the chapter is ending where the author is giving a question. The author is putting a question on us that how we accept the child labor and how we directly or indirectly get involved, and how these people are having a vicious circle of complications. One circle is of their ancestral bondage, ki agar wo rag picker hain, to wo rag picker hi rahenge. Ya fir wo bangle maker hain, to wo bangle maker hi rahenge. One is that of ancestral profession. Another vicious circle is of middlemen, policemen, the people in authority, that how they are not doing anything for the upliftment of these kind of people. They are all the time working on that how these people can be exploited, and they are only making the money for themselves. Yes, so the caste, their lower means lower profile, all these are being enforced through the chapter to make us analyze that how we are directly or indirectly involved in the whole matter. Yes, so we are not going to the extracts. Literary devices are there, but before that, I want to show you how difficult it is, the profession of bangle making. Let me stop sharing for a minute. Yes, Karthik, now are you able to relate to some extent to the chapter? Karthik?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you able to relate to the chapter to some extent?
Thoda thoda.
Chalo, theek hai, koi baat nahi. Abhi, this is the thing that I'm going to share related to bangle making, so that we all should realize how difficult, how hazardous the bangle making thing is. Then I'll take you to the notes that you can refer to for the summary, and we will discuss the chapter once again with all the perspectives that we need to know. Yes?
बैंगल्स का ही है। बैंगल्स के बाद यहाँ ग्लास शुरू हुआ है। पहले यहाँ से फिरोजाबाद सिर्फ सेल करने के लिए आया करती थी बैंगल।
अरे पिताजी करते थे पहले ये काम। पिताजी के इस पार होने के बाद में ये काम हमने किया।
हमारे बाप दादा को बाप दादे और बाप दादे काफी अरसे चल रहा है बड़ी काम तो।
काम आठ साल की उम्र से कर रहे हैं। जब सीख गए तो आदत बन गई है, करते हैं। पहले टाइम लगता था, अब नहीं लगता।
हमको खुद नहीं मालूम कि हम कितने साल के थे। बहुत छोटे थे, काफी छोटे थे। आज हमको कम से कम ये समझ लो, आज हमें काम इस गर्म काम में घुसे हुए आज कम से कम 35 साल करीब हो गए।
प्रॉब्लम तो होता ही है, थोड़ा सा गर्मी है उस वजह से।
सेफ्टी के लिए यहाँ कुछ भी नहीं है। सेफ्टी के लिए अगर हाथ कट भी जाता है तो ये सुतलियाँ हैं, सुतलियाँ इनको निकाल लीजिए और यूँ करके बांध लीजिए। खून रुक जाएगा कुछ देर के लिए, फिर फेंक दीजिए। यही पट्टी है यहाँ पर।
यहाँ तो जलते ही रहते हैं, जलने ही काम है। ये काम ऐसा है कि यहाँ कोई किसी का वो नहीं है। आज आ गया कल तो कल दूसरा आ जाएगा। आज मैंने कर लिया, कल दूसरा कर गया, परसों कोई और कर गया।
छुट्टी वगैरह पड़ती है, रजिस्टर्ड छुट्टी पड़ती है, त्योहार वगैरह, इतवार वगैरह, संडे वगैरह, इसके कोई पैसा नहीं मिलता हम लोगों को।
So did you see how the bangles are made? Yes, how the hazardous work is done in the mines, in those furnaces, how the molten glass is then framed into bangles. Aur aapne dekha tha, wo old man, he was continuously wiping off his eyes. So see the irony of their fate, that the people who are making bangles in their own life, in their own family, the women are devoid, but the women are not having that fate to wear the bangles for a long time because they lose their husbands. Either the husbands means either the males in the family lose their eyes, their eyesight, or they die in that profession at a very early age. Yes, so aap log relate kar paaye? Were you able to understand that how hazardous is the bangle making thing and how the children below 14 years of age or 13 years of age are put into the thing, and what kind of mentality, what kind of ideology these people have, ki hamare to pardada dada karte rahe hain, hum bhi kar rahe hain, pata nahi kab se kar rahe hain. Yes, so that mental pressure is also there. So let us, I'm all again sharing my screen. We will now discuss with the notes. Yes, Harshit I think has left. स्क्रीन दिख रही है मेरी? मोहित, मोहित?
यस मैम।
यस, इज माय स्क्रीन विजिबल विद द नोट्स?
यस मैम, इट इज विजिबल।
ओके, सो नाउ बॉयज, वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट the chapter with complete details, and I hope you are now going to relate to the things that we need to understand in with perspective of answering the questions. Yes. So I am not going into the about the author, the introduction, all these things. We are going to talk about straight away to the gist of the lesson. Yes. Mohit, would you read?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Gist of the lesson. The author examines and analyzes the impoverished conditions and traditions that condemn children to a life of exploitation. These children are denied an education and forced into hardships early in their lives. The writer encounters Sahib Rag Picker, whose parents have left behind the life of poverty in the Dhaka to earn a living in Delhi. His family, like many other families of rag pickers, lives in Simapuri. They do not have other identification other than a ration card. The children do not go to school, and they are excited at the prospect of finding a coin or even a 10 rupee note for
rummaging. Matlab kya hota hai? Dhoondna.
Rummaging in the garbage. It is the only way of earning the life. They live in impoverished conditions but are resigned.
Continue, Mohit.
Of their fate. The writer is pained to see Sahib, a rag picker whose name means the ruler of the earth, loses the spark of childhood and roams barefooted with his friends. From morning to noon, the author encounters him in a tea stall where he is paid 800 rupees. He sadly realizes that he is no longer his master, and this loss of identity weighs heavily on his tender shoulders.
Yes, Mohit,
the author.
Mohit, stop it. Yes. So we came to know about Sahib, who is a rag picker. Yes. Now Sahib is a rag picker. He has been here because they came from Dhaka long time back. Dhaka is in Bangladesh. Now, and then they settled in Simapuri, and Sahib was working as a rag picker. So Sahib, who was up till now free, up till now was the owner of his own life, ruler of his own life, was now being employed in a tea stall. Aapne dekha hoga chote-chote bachcho ko tea stall mein kaam karte ho. Yes, how they are roaming around with those tea stands, tea cups in their hand, giving tea to everyone. Yes, or jo waiters hotels mein bhi jo aap jab dhabo pe jaate ho ya fir countryside pe jab aap jaate ho, you must have seen how the young children are employed there to work. So Sahib has been working like that, and he's been paid rupees 800, and he is no longer the master, the ruler of his own life. He can't do anything with his own will, and he is given his 3 times meal. But he is not that much cheerful as he was able to enjoy his life as a rag picker. Though his family would be secured now that they will be able to get some kind of meal for themselves. But Sahib has lost his childhood. Yes. Now we are going to know about another victim, Mukesh. Yes. So Karthik. Karthik.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Bacha. Read. The author then tells about another victim. Third pointer, third bullet on the screen.
The author then tells about another victim, Mukesh, who wants to be a motor mechanic. Hailing from Firozabad, the center of India's bangle making and glass blowing industry, he has always worked in the glass making industry. His family, like the others, they do not know that it is illegal for children to work in such close proximity to furnace in such high temperature. They are exposed to various health hazards, like losing their eyesight as they work in
abysmal
Alzheimer's condition in dark and dingy cells. Mukesh's father is blind, as were his father, grandfather before him.
Continue.
The lead a hand to mouth exercise as they caught in the victim which vicious web of the money lender, middleman, police and the tradition. So burdened are the bangle maker or the Firozabad that they have lost the ability to dream, unlike Mukesh who dreams of driving a car.
Yes. So there is now another boy, Mukesh. Now Mukesh is not having that lack of dreams as others have. Though he's coming from Firozabad, he is still employed in the glass making industry. He talks about the various kind of health hazards like losing eyesight, the lack of conditions, health conditions, working in dark and dingy cells. It becomes really difficult. His father became blind. His grandfather became blind and lost their life when they were doing work. So they are leading a hand-to-mouth existence. Hand-to-mouth means jitna kamate hain, utna sab kuch lag jata. Yes? Jitna wo log kamate hain, utna hi sab kuch wo kharch ho jata. So they are leading hand-to-mouth existence. Yes. And they are caught in the vicious web. Vicious web means wo jo spiral-like structure hota na, ki aap kahin se bhi chale jao, par aapko end nahi milega. So that is a vicious web. They are there in that never-ending circle of money lenders, middlemen, police, and the ancestral tradition that they have to be in this profession because it is their ancestral profession. So the burdens, the atrocities on the bangle makers of Firozabad are explained here. And these atrocities, these burdens have forced the people that they can't dream anything. But Mukesh is different because he is still willing to dream that he is going to drive a car soon. Yes, he would learn to be a motor mechanic and he will drive a car soon. So let us move further. I hope you are able to relate to the story now. Can I have your thumbs up if you are able to relate to the story? Akshat, are you able to understand the things? Yes. Harshit? Ho aap? No, I don't think Harshit is there. Harshit nahi hai. Okay. Chalo, then let's move on further. Thank you, boys. Thank you, Karthik. Thank you, Mohit. You can lower down your thumb. Yes. So now we are going on to the theme. Yes. So Karthik ne padha tha. Mohit ne bhi padha tha shayad. Akshat reh gaya. Akshat, you have not read na? Akshat?
Yes, ma'am.
Aapne padh liya?
Nahin, ma'am.
Chalo, aap padho. Theme.
Theme. Theme, the lesson deal with diet of the children who are forced into labor early in life and then with the opportunity to better their circumstances to assist to education. The vicious circle of poverty, governmental apathy, and exploitation in girls' health. The story also highlights the indifferent attitude of the society and the political class towards the problem of child labor.
Yes. So the theme means the central idea. The central idea of the chapter is to expose the plight of the children, the state of the children who are forced into labor. Child labor very early in their life and they are not able to enjoy their childhood or the better circumstances or the opportunity to be educated. The never-ending circle of poverty, governmental apathy. Apathy means lack of interest, and exploitation engulfs their childhood completely. It is also talking about how society is indifferent, that people know that these all things exist, but the people in power don't even pay a heed to the problem of child labor. Yes. So now we are going to talk about what the title is talking. That lost spring has a tinge of irony. Irony, maine aap logo ko bataya tha. Irony is when literal meaning is different from the inherent meaning, exactly opposite. Literal meaning is exactly opposite of the inherent meaning. Spring is the season of optimism and hope. Humne baat ki thi last class mein, how spring denotes blooming of flowers, beauty, flourishing nature, optimism, hope, because we all hope that things like new life is going to take birth as it takes place in case of flowers. trees also are bubbling up with fruits that we enjoy in the time of summer season. So spring is the metaphor of childhood, the childhood stage in a person's life. From birth till late childhood, the life of every child is almost the beginning of their bright and shiny future. Childhood is always accompanied by innocence, stamina, energy, and so many desires for outdoors and a tremendous appetite, hunger for fun and play. At this time, you must have known, आप लोगों ने अगर कोई research पढ़ी हो या आप लोगों को पता हो, आप लोगों को पता है कि आप लोगों को language जो सिखाते हैं, three language formula जो है, ये 13 years या 14 years की age तक क्यों चलता है? जब आप छोटे होते हो, आप लोगों को सबसे पहले कौन सी language सिखाते हैं? English सिखाना शुरू करते हैं, फिर हिंदी introduce करते हैं, उसके बाद sixth standard onwards third language introduce करते हैं, because it is believed कि इस age में जो 4 years onwards जो बच्चे की age होती है, 3 to 4 years onwards, children learn the most when they observe the people around them. आप लोगों के घर में अगर cousins में छोटे siblings हों, you must have observed किया कभी उन्हें? How when they are 2 years old, they start babbling, baba, papa, mama, and then they move on by copying the same sentence. देखा है कभी कार्तिक अक्षत मोहित? So at this stage, yes, Mohit, you want to say?
Ma'am, I was saying that yes, देखा.
Yes, okay. So you must have seen that how by just listening to the people around, just noticing their conversation, hearing their conversation, how children learn. So this is the best age to learn. And these kind of children like Sahib and Mukesh are underprivileged, impoverished regarding their health. And for them, this childhood, this aspect of childhood is missing because they have lost their childhood in child labor. So the writer is beautifully trying to portray the story of stolen childhood so that the readers can be made awaken to the condition of these children who are unfortunate, unlucky, and nobody is there to pay attention to their conditions. Yes, I hope you are able to connect to the title. That कहने को हम कहते हैं कि spring season जो सबसे beautiful season होता है, season of enjoyment, season of hope, optimism. पर यहाँ हमारे पास वो बच्चे हैं कि जिनका वो स्प्रिंग सीजन उस एज में होते हुए भी जिनके पास वो सीजन मिसिंग है बिकॉज ऑफ देयर सर्कमस्टेंसेस, बिकॉज ऑफ द कंडीशन दे आर बोर्न इन, राइट? सो नाउ लेट अस लुक एट सम ऑफ द इंपॉर्टेंट कोट्स दैट वी नीड टू पे अटेंशन टू. चलो फिर से मोहित बेटा रीड. Mohit, are you there? Mohit? No. Kartik?
Yes, ma'am.
Achha. Kartik, achha, wait. Mohit, better start reading.
Yes, ma'am. Simapuri, a place on the periphery of Delhi, yet miles away from it. Simapuri is geographically close to Delhi. Simapuri is geographically close to Delhi. But its tradition, standard of life, and the people are far away from Delhi, which is thriving metro city with all the amenities, and is a seat of power. For the children, it is wrapped in the wonder. For the adults, it is a means of survival. The elders have made it their profession for a fixed wage. Whereas for the children, rag picking is the game of treasure hunting. They work through the garbage with a hope that one day they would get a gold coin or a rupee note from the garbage heap. Through the years, rag pickers has acquired the proportions of a fine art. Like any other art, from rag picking processes, certain talents and rules. One needs guidance and inborn talents to be a successful rag picker. He should know where to find garbage, what to take, what to ignore, what time is the best for it, and so on. In Simapuri, every child is skilled in this art form. The steel canister seems heavier over his shoulders. Sahib is now employed in a tea shop with a fixed wage of 800 rupees and all means. He is not happy as he has lost his freedom, as he is bound to the owner of the tea stall, who is the master. He is no longer his own master.
Okay, Mohit, will I stop? Mohit, stop.
Okay.
Kartik.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, bacha. Little has moved with time in Firozabad.
कहाँ से?
Last bullet on the page.
Little has moved with time in Firozabad. Though law have been made against child labor, child still continue to work in the bangle industry in Firozabad. The children working in the industry are exploited by the money lenders, the middleman and the bureaucrats. Even the police do not protect them. They lead a miserable and hard life. They live and work in inhuman condition. In fact, Little has moved within Little have moved with the time in the city of Bangalmaker. They are as poor and miserable as they were before.
Okay. Kartik, let us stop. Yes. So I hope all these statements are clear. These are the some of the important quotes. Koi quote agar nahi samajha, you can raise a hand. Kartik, Akshat, Mohit. Any quote which is not clear, any line from the book. These are the italics ones, are the line from your book. Simapuri, a place on the Paris yet miles away from it. I will talk about what technique has been used by the author to indirectly comment on the situation. Abhi dekho, abhi chhod. Hai koi problem? Kartik, Akshat, Mohit. बड़े आगे यस
no.
किसी ने हाथ रेज तो किया था शायद कार्तिक
मैम मोहित मैम
ओके मोहित यू वांट टू से समथिंग
यस मैम मैम देयर इज अ वर्ड मैम कैनिस्टर व्हाट दिस मींस
कैनिस्टर वो आपने देखा है वो, जब वो आपने कभी देखा होगा कि पापा या मम्मा जब दूध लेने जाते हैं तो वो कैनिस्टर होता है उनके हाथ में वो डोल जो होता है दैट इज स्टील कैनिस्टर राइट
यस मैम
ठीक है तो अब की बार जब कोई डोल लेके जाए ना तो कहना पुट दैट कैनिस्टर इन द राइट सेंस आना पहले तो आपकी शक्ल भी देखता रहेगा क्या बोल रहे हो समझ नहीं आ
ओके मैम
कमिंग टू द पॉइंट एनी अदर डाउट इन कोट्स में जो इन पॉइंट्स में फ्रॉम द टेक्स्ट बुक मोहित अक्षत कार्तिक नहीं तो आगे चलते चलो यस अब दिस इज अ माइंड मैप Yes. And this is basically focusing on Mukesh's life. Padho ise jaldi se padho. Give a silent reading. Firstly, Anne's junk visits Mukesh's house. A half-built shack with thatched dead grass. Roof and a wobbly iron door. Houses, three generations are staying there. Grandmother, father, elder brother and his wife. Mukesh's father, who is the head of the family, is poverty stricken. He is unable to renovate the house or provide education to his two sons, Mukesh and his elder brother. The only legacy is something that you are carrying with you as a part of ancestral property or ancestral knowledge. Is the art of bangle making. Grandmother believes that the art of bangle making is given by God. This kind of ancestral history has been given by God. God has chosen this profession for the whole family. And the state of affairs, the present poverty is due to our karma in the past life. Ye hum logo ka bhi belief hota hai. When something occurs to us or when we are suffering, maybe we have done a lot of bad deeds in the past birth, in the past life. That's why we are suffering in this life for our previous attempts, for our previous life's actions. Yes. So now, in Firozabad, the time is still standing. no progress, no development, no sign of such. And poverty, illiteracy, dissatisfaction are all visible. All laborers are victim of middlemen and touts. Touts kaun hote? Touts kaun hote? जो एक काला बाजारी करते हैं ना, आपसे एक का लिया और आगे 50 का बेच दिया, दे आर टाउट्स, राइट? सो द विक्टिम, द चिल्ड्रन आर द विक्टिम ऑफ टू वर्ल्ड्स. फर्स्टली दे आर बोर्न इन पॉवर्टी रिडन फैमिली एंड देन देयर कास्ट इज अ बर्डन टू देम. सेकेंडली दे आर विक्टिम ऑफ अ होपलेस सिचुएशन ruled by sahukar, middlemen, policemen, bureaucrat and politicians. They are desirous to dream, means their desires to dream and to do something for them are all curbed out due to their childhood and their, means due to their condition, their circumstances. Now there is a boy in the same family, Mukesh. He says, I want to drive a car. Mukesh is a child laborer in glass factory in Firozabad. He aspires to be a motor mechanic. He wants to learn to drive a car. He also realizes that dreaming of aeroplanes would be overreaching himself. Though he wants that he should be one day flying the aeroplane, but he thinks that he is going to overdream. Also, his family is unaware that child labor is illegal and banned by the law. Apart from this, adding to their trouble is the condition in glass furnaces, as we have just seen, high temperatures, dingy cells, dark cells without air and light. Children lose their eyesight at a very early age. And the living conditions even are not good. The lanes are stinking. The houses are having weak walls, wobbly doors. Wobbly means clinky doors, the doors which make a lot of noise, no windows. Humans and animals are living together. The only solution to work out the matter is the police are now all mixed up. The police is also having a joint hand with the people in power and nobody is taking action. Nobody is taking any leadership among the people. Yes, and the trap laid by middlemen deters their growth. They are caught in a vicious circle that from poverty, they are going to the indifference hands of greed and injustice. Yes, so these are some of the things that we are observing through the chapter, that how these people are suffering. Now let us talk about the thing. अभी आप लोगों ने quotes देखे जो हमने पढ़े थे, सीमा पुरी और ये वाले जो quotes थे. अब यहाँ पे वो बात हो रही कि इन quotes को poet ने किस intention से use किया. Yes, hyperbole. अब hyperbole क्या होता है? हमने याद है poetic devices की बात की थी, है याद? Alliteration, personification, consonants, assonance. Do you remember, Karthik, Mohit?
Yes.
So now hyperbole is one of the poetic device. Hyperbole mein kya hota hai? Kisi bhi cheez ko bada chada ke bolna. It is a way of speaking or writing that makes something sound better or more exciting than it really is. Garbage to them is gold. A poet has intention, author has intentionally used it. Garbage to them is gold. Why? Because for children, it is a thing of wonder. Pata nahi aaj kude mein unhe kya mil jaye. And for elders, it is a means of survival. That's why it is as valuable to these people as gold is to all of us. Yes? Then, paradox. Paradox aap padho. Kisne nahi padha tha abhi? Akshat ne nahi padha tha shayad. Akshat, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, bacha, read.
Paradox. A paradox is a statement, a concept that contains conflicted ideas in logic. A paradox is a statement that contradicts
itself. Poverty of Sahib and richness of the tennis club. The statement is one, yes, but two conflicting, means two opposing ideas come together in the same statement. The poverty of Sahib is contrasted to the richness, how the rich people come in the tennis club. This is actually the scene in the chapter when Sahib is going for that rag picking thing, and he observes the people in the tennis club playing tennis, and he shares his desire that one day he also wants to wear those tennis shoes. After some time, he observes that somebody has kept a pair of shoes with a hole. A pair of shoes where one shoe is having a hole. Yes. So at that point, he gets those shoes and he's more than happy. He's really excited because as he has got something very valuable. For him, those shoes with a hole are much more valuable than anyone of us can even imagine, because for us, when a thing is having a hole, or when a thing is trodden or means worn out, we throw it. But for these children, such kind of things are more valuable than their own life. So he's extremely happy when he gets those shoes, that someday he would also be playing the tennis like them. Now, metaphor humne already baat ki thi, indirect comparison. Web of poverty. You have seen a spider web. Yes, spider web, and it is very difficult. It becomes so sticky. Aapne dekha hoga, jab bhi spider web mein koi fas jata hai, any creature, any insect, it is impossible for that insect to come out. In the same manner, for these children, they are caught in the web of poverty. Drowned in air of desolation. Yes, like we all, those of us who don't know swimming, when we go into water, we get drowned. So in the same manner, these children are not looked after. Their caste, their people are not looked after. Nobody bothers about them. That's why they are drowning in the air due to desolation, due to loneliness, lack of care and concern. She still has bangles on her wrist, but not light in her eyes. Now this is talked about the grandmother, who is wearing the bangles, but has lost her eyesight due to working in the furnace. Now, hyperboles once again, scrounging for gold. This scrounging for gold is the case of rag pickers, that how they rummage, how they look, how they search through the garbage, as if they are going to find a very useful, and generally what they found a 10 rupee note or a coin. Garbage to them is gold. We already talked about it. Paradoxes. Sahib-e-Alam means Lord of the Universe. And is in contrast to what Sahib is. He is a rag picker. Simapuri is a place of abundant riches. But in reality, Simapuri means the borderline of something. Sima is what? The boundary of something. Yes. But in reality, Simapuri is a slum inhabited by the squatter. Squatter kaun hote hain? Aap logon ne gym karte hue dekha hoga apne aap ko dhyan se. When you bend down on your knees without touching your body to any part, only your toes or your feet are touching the ground, then it is squatting. Yes. But here, squatters means the people who have come from Bangladesh. Yes, a wilderness devoid of basic amenities. So these people have come and they are not having any kind of useful facilities, any kind of better living conditions. Similes, as her hands move mechanically like the tongs of the machines. You have seen mechanical machines kaise kaam karti hain? Unke aage jo instruction unhe di hoti hai, they follow that instruction. Whether an animal comes in front, whether the object comes in front, their task is to complete their part. Yes. What they are given. So in the same manner, this girl is doing all that work without any concern. Ki jaise unke abhi aap logon ne us documentary mein bhi dekha ki kaise log kaam karte ja rahe hain, they are not having any concern ki kya ho raha hai aaspas. Yes. Okay. So now let us move to the next part. Now this is answer the following. Discuss karna ek baar. Mention the hazards of working in a glass bangle factory. Ab kaun answer karega? Jaldi se hand raise karo. Raise your hand. Koi bhi nahi, aise mat karo bhi. Raise your hand. Yes, Mohit.
Ma'am, ma'am burns due to the furnaces.
Yes.
And they... ma'am cuts in hands while working with the glass.
Yes, they get cuts in their hand, bruises in their hands, body when they are working with the glass. What else? Long term.
Ma'am, stiffness.
Bolo.
Ma'am, their eyes also affected.
Yes, working. Their eyes are also affected because they are working in dark, dingy cells where light is not there. Yes, they lose their eyesight. What was the Sahib's full name? Was it a suitable name for him? Why or why not? Mohit already answered kar chuka. Mohit, you can lower down your hand. Karthik, Akshat. Try karo. Karthik, Akshat. What was his full name? Sahib's full name. Bahut simple sa question hai.
Sahib-e-Alam.
Yes. And was it a suitable name for him?
No, ma'am.
No. अब कार्तिक और अक्षत में से मुझे बताएंगे कि ये नाम suitable क्यों नहीं था? कार्तिक, साहिब आलम was not a suitable name for the boy. Why? कार्तिक मैंने इतना बुरा पढ़ाया. अक्षत, चलो कार्तिक लास्ट क्लास में नहीं था. अक्षत आप हो? अक्षत नहीं, अक्षत इज नॉट देयर. ओके मोहित, यू आंसर.
मैम एक्चुअली साहिबे आलम मींस द वर्ड, दिस नेम मींस द एम्परर ऑफ द होल वर्ल्ड, बट मैम एज कंपेयर टू साहिब, एज ही इज अ रैग पिकर, मैम ही इज अ रैग पिकर एंड मैम ही इज द he's a master of his rag picking, and ma'am, this name is not suitable for him as he's poor, and ma'am, he is a rag picker.
Yes, Sahib's full name is Sahib-e-Alam. Sahib-e-Alam means the means emperor of the whole universe or lord of the whole universe. Yes, this was not a suitable name for him because he was firstly only a rag picker. Secondly, he used to claim that he was the owner of his own life, but eventually we see that the boy who was loitering in the streets picking up the rags had lost the ownership of his own life, because at the end of the story he is working as a child, means a servant in a child in a tea stall. Yes, he is working in a tea stall for 800 rupees per month and his 3 times meal, so he has lost that right over his own life as well. That's why this name Sahib-e-Alam is not a suitable name for him. Yes. Okay, would you agree that promises made to the poor children are rarely kept? Why do you think this happens in the incidents narrated in the text? Batao. Are the promises made to the poor children kept or rarely kept? Chalo, main iska answer deti because we have not talked about it. Mujhe pata hai text aap sabne nahi padha. The promises made to the poor children are rarely kept. The reason being that all these promises, means for example, the author asks Sahib half jokingly that whether he will come to her school if she starts a school. And Sahib willingly agrees that yes, I'll join that school. A few days later, he asks the author that if the school is ready, and the writer feels really embarrassed that she made a promise that was not meant to be fulfilled. Promise that she made like her, many other people made, and in their world, people generally made such kind of promises, but they were never fulfilled. Yes? And these incidents are narrated ki agar ek elite class ka bachcha hota hai, jab usse koi promise kiya jata hai, the parents try their neck and heart to prove it, to fulfill it. But in the case of these kind of children, such promises are never fulfilled. Now, justify the title, Lost Spring. कार्तिक, अब ये तो आप कर सकते हो. कार्तिक, मोहित ने तो हाथ खड़ा कर ही लिया. Karthik, I think yes, you can ma'am. Manage. Justify the title Lost Spring. Batao. Okay, Mohit, you say.
Ma'am, the lost spring here is compared with the childhood of the children who are not able to get the opportunity to study and to live in a better conditions, ma'am. The world is described without any spring, ma'am. If the child are working in the tea stalls or rag picking, ma'am, the Bengals, their childhood is lost. And ma'am, the children are living without any childhood, ma'am, because the childhood is lost in working on the tea stalls and ma'am, working on the bangle shop or rag picking.
Okay. So what we are talking about is lost spring. Firstly, we will describe spring. Spring here describes or talks about the childhood. Yes, like spring is a season of hope, optimism, blooming flowers. In the same manner, childhood is the time of flourishing, hopes, planning for future, joyfulness, hope, concern. Yes, and that never, innocence. But in case of all these children that we have come to know about through this text, the children have lost their childhood. Due to child labor. Yes, they have lost their childhood due to child labor. The children are no more able to enjoy their life the way they want. They are bound by their family foundations. Not only this, they are bound by their ancestral traditions. Apart from this, their family, the middlemen, police, everything, the circumstances are totally against them. Yes, so that's why the chapter is entitled in the correct sense that the children who are symbolizing the childhood, that is symbolizing spring, this time has been lost for these children because they are burdened with the responsibilities, with the expectations, and with the lack of resources that can build up their life. Right? Yes? Okay. Which day is observed as the anti-child labor day? Pata hai, Mohit, Karthik ka to mujhe lagta hai kuch connection ka problem ho gaya. June 12 is the anti-child labor day. Right? I'm stopping the screen sharing. चलो मोहित कोई डाउट है तो पूछो आप. आई थिंक यू आर द ओनली वन लेफ्ट. मोहित एनी डाउट?
नो मैम, नॉट डाउट, नो डाउट एज सच.
चैप्टर समझ आ गया?
यस मैम.
सो बट डू वन थिंग, बस गो थ्रू द चैप्टर वंस अगेन सो दैट द चैप्टर इज मींस द टेक्स्ट वाइज यू शुड बी एक्वेंटेड विद द चैप्टर टू अंडरस्टैंड इट बेटर. रेस्ट एवरीथिंग एंड the notes that I shared in the class today through PDF, it will be sent to you soon. आप लोगों ने गौरव सर से पूछा था?
No ma'am.
करना, गौरव सर से बात करना, फिर वो क्या कहते हैं, ठीक है? Notes के बारे में. Okay.
Okay. चलो. Okay.
On this note, कोई doubt हो तो पूछ लो, otherwise you can also leave.
Okay. Ma'am, no doubt ma'am.
Okay बच्चा. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye, man.
Bye.